America has just released these spectacular pictures of atomic tests.
Заявите четко, что мы готовы остановить войну, что мы уходим из Южной Осетии, что мы готовы подписать.
The political image of our planet today is a constantly changing structure. Stable models of statehood and long-standing international relationships coexist with new threats and challenges.
Заявите четко, что мы готовы остановить войну, что мы уходим из Южной Осетии.
Government officials and diplomats, professionals with a broad expertise in international relations, law, economics, and world cultures, face numerous tasks today. They include formulating adequate responses to a changing world, preventing conflicts, and laying down principles of international relations in a period of globalization. This country needs diplomats who are able to develop efficient forms of international cooperation while pursuing the national interests of Russia. It is the top priority of any state to nurture such professionals. There are people in Russia who are ready to learn this demanding craft. There are educators who are able to pass on the finer points of diplomatic skills. There is an academic institution that prepares personnel to represent Russia's interests internationally. In 1934, the USSR joined the League of Nations and became one of the leading political players in Europe. Diplomatic relationships demanded new and better prepared personnel. As a result, an Institute for Diplomatic and Consular Personnel was established with the USSR International Relations People's Commissariat by the Organizational Bureau of the All-Union Bolsheviks Communist Party Central Committee on July 29, 1934. The mission of the Institute was to prepare vice consuls, attachés, desk officers, and secretaries for embassies. 1934 was the year when a systematic approach to training diplomatic personnel was initiated. This year is considered the Academy's year of birth. The Academy is 75 today. This institution would not gain the status of an academy until 1974. But before that happened, the future academy and the country would have to pass through numerous ordeals, shoulder to shoulder. Throughout the years of its existence, the Academy was fully involved in the life of the nation and never hid from hardship behind the walls of its stony stronghold in the center of Moscow. When the Great Patriotic War broke out, the majority of students of the Higher Diplomatic School, as the institution was called at that time, joined the militia, and some were called up. Many did not come back. Later, a memorial plaque was displayed in the Academy to honor the memory of employees and students who were killed in the Great Patriotic War. After the war, the international situation changed drastically. The balance of power and interests shifted. New relationships emerged in the course of the Cold War, and Diplomatic Academy graduates had new problems to solve. Bright stars rose from the ranks of graduates in the temple of diplomatic fame. Nikolai Bulichov, Sergei Tikhvinsky, Sergei Romanovsky, Oleg Perisipkin, Anatoly Dobrynin, Yuri Kashlev, Yuri Fokin, Alexander Lebedev, Viktor Popov, Valentina Matvienko. These people and other professionals have worked hard to attain important political goals in the interests of Russia over the years. This is the Diplomatic Academy today. It is situated in the center of Moscow in an ancient four-storied building constructed in 1875. The mansion is protected by the government as a piece of cultural heritage. Academy facilities include 60 classrooms, two conference halls with a joint capacity of 160 seats, and two lecture halls with 60 seats each. Classes for 1,400 students can be conducted simultaneously. Nowadays, the Academy is a multidisciplinary institution of higher education. Diplomats and public servants involved in international activities are trained and improve their qualifications here. The Academy provides training in the following specializations: international relations, international economics, and international law. It prepares scientific and analytical papers aimed at teaching relevant theoretical and practical facets of modern diplomacy and Russia's international policy. Modern technical facilities and information technology are used in the learning process. There are free computer classrooms with internet access, equipment for simultaneous translation, and a digital system for roundtable discussions. The Academy's library and reference room holds ample stocks of scientific and educational titles for professors and students, who also have a wide selection of periodicals in many languages at their fingertips. The Academy also has state-of-the-art recreation and sport facilities. Students can do aerobics, gymnastics, badminton, volleyball, tennis, and other kinds of sport under the guidance of experienced coaches. A number of good traditions have formed at the Academy in recent years. Among these are regular meetings with prominent people, for example, Irina Rodnina, and exhibitions of modern painters, especially young ones, from Russia and abroad. The Academy holds thematic book exhibitions, as well as exhibitions of unique archive documents, art, and documentary photography. But what does this have to do with learning or with science? Well, a diplomat is first and foremost a professional with an all-round education. It is the aim of the Academy to expand the minds of future international professionals through supporting and promoting young talent. The Academy is 75 today. 75 years of priceless experience which needs to be saved and passed on to future generations. Here they are, future masters of the diplomatic universe. They are the Academy students today, and tomorrow they will follow in the path of Troyanovsky, Dobrynin, Popov, highly educated specialists in the sphere of politics and diplomacy. They will become professionals with a deep knowledge of international relations, law, economics, and world cultures. They are the people who will protect Russia in the international field. They are able to give early warning of an imminent conflict, assess the situation promptly, and have the decision-making authority to resolve it. They will help Russia become even more powerful and more open to the dialogue of cultures and civilizations.
Дорогие друзья, разрешите присоединиться к тем поздравлениям, которые...
Dear friends, I would like to join in congratulations on the 75th anniversary of the Academy. The Academy has passed a long and glorious path. It has many achievements that it can be indeed proud of. Over these years, since 1934, when an Institute for Diplomatic and Consular Personnel was established, through the stage of higher diplomatic school, and since 1974 as Diplomatic Academy, it has prepared 20,000 professionals in all spheres of international relations, among them 8,000 diplomats, including 500 ambassadors, and 2,500 foreign citizens were educated in the Academy. We still feel results of this work when we meet our foreign colleagues who hold major posts in their countries and have warm memories about the knowledge they gained in the Academy and speak highly of their friends that they have found in Russia. The Academy makes an important contribution not only to personnel preparation for the Ministry of Foreign Affairs, and we recruit at least 20 Academy graduates annually, but to personnel preparations for the whole government. Many public servants involved in international activities have improved their qualifications here, both by learning foreign languages and getting a better understanding of the subtleties of multilateral diplomacy, which is developing in the spheres of politics, economy, ecology, and other spheres. I would also like to thank the staff of the Academy for their intellectual contribution that they and our colleagues from the Moscow State Institute of International Relations make to provide conceptual scaffolding for Russia's foreign policy. It has tangibly materialized in the contribution that professors of the Academy and its think tanks have made to prepare Russia's foreign policy concept that was approved by President Dmitry Medvedev in July 2008. We hope that the Academy will continue to match high international standards in terms of scientific and educational efforts, and that it will further advance Russia's foreign policy course, which is aimed at strengthening the rule of international law, the strengthening of UN's central role, and securing Russia's positions in international affairs. I wish everyone professional success, good health, and happiness.
Годы учебы в дипломатической академии всегда вспоминаю с большой теплотой.
I always remember the years I spent at the Diplomatic Academy with warmth. I studied in the old building in Большой Козловский Lane from 1975 till 1978. I am very grateful to the vice professors and lecturers who taught me the basics of foreign service. These are well-known diplomats. Виктор Попов, who was director of the Academy then, Андрей Степанов, my academic advisor and vice-chancellor of the Academy, Валерьян Зорин, Федор Млычков, Михаил Капица, Игорь Земсков, Асторий Овсяный, Авалков, and many others. As the CIS Executive Committee Chairman, may I remark that it was also a school of internationalism, because I studied together with the envoys of all former Soviet republics, who had really good collegial relationships. I remember my fellow students, for example, Петр Чхидзе from Georgia, Володя Тимошенко from Kyiv, Ашот Егиазарьян from Yerevan, and many others who later became ambassadors, and Ashot Yegiazaryan became Armenia's first foreign affairs minister. I know that today there are even more foreign students in the Academy, first and foremost from CIS countries. I sincerely hope that when they go back home, they will favor strong ties with Russia and create a strong CIS, because it is much easier for us to protect the common interests of our countries together to strengthen the international standing of our nations. I thank the Academy from the depths of my heart for the school of life that it has been to me, and sincerely wish every success to all the professors, lecturers, and students.
The Diplomatic Academy is 75. It is a wonderful age, and your achievements are remarkable. You are a powerful scientific center. You have a great team of well-known scientists in the field of international relations. You have a high level of language teaching here, which is especially important now, when Russian international professionals are not just actively participating in forums and conferences, but set the tone there with their keynote speeches and documents. One, two, three, or four languages are not enough anymore, and the Academy is training such personnel. I would also underscore that it is necessary to have a good command of Russian. Unfortunately, our language is under heavy influence of pseudo-culture, the Eratz culture of consumer society. It has always been a trait of a diplomat that he has a good mastery of his native language, and the Academy has contributed to this a lot. The Academy has excellent staff, intelligent students, and is doing very important work in training diplomats of the 21st and 22nd century.
The Diplomatic Academy is 75, but it has a glorious predecessor, the Lyceum in Tsarskoye Selo, which existed for more than a century. Pushkin, Gorchakov, and five Russian foreign ministers have graduated from it. That's why we are proud of what we have, and what we have is marvelous. Look at the Ministry of Foreign Affairs. I believe that more than a half of ambassadors and foreign policy makers are Diplomatic Academy graduates. That's what we have to be proud of, and we are proud of it indeed.
First of all, I would like to congratulate the entire staff of the Diplomatic Academy of the Ministry of Foreign Affairs, all its students, everyone who has supported the Diplomatic Academy in its activities for 75 years. We are proud of the Academy's glorious traditions. We are proud of its lecturers, but most of all, we are proud of its graduates, who work for the benefit of Russia's interests in major diplomatic posts, in government agencies, in large corporations, in research and development centers. I am sure the Academy will continue to do its utmost to ensure that Russia is represented internationally by the best professionals, by the best diplomats, by the best representatives of our intelligentsia. The Diplomatic Academy looks to the future with optimism. We invite everyone who wants to be actively involved in advancing this country's foreign policy to study in our Academy. We will provide all the necessary conditions for that. Please come, and we hope that when you graduate as a high-profile specialist, you will find your vocation in this new profession.
Congratulations on this anniversary to all the educators of the Diplomatic Academy. Thank you for the warmth, and I thank Evgeny Primakov personally for helping us, sportsmen, by giving such a good start in life. May God help the Academy to find even more educators as outstanding as those who teach here now. Happy anniversary.
On this remarkable day, the anniversary of the Diplomatic Academy, from the bottom of my heart, I would like to congratulate our dear professors and lecturers and thank them for the knowledge we get here.
Our Academy is 75 years old. Here we can acquire knowledge which is most accurate at this time. I would like to congratulate the Academy and our teachers and wish them success as well as intelligent graduates.
I would like to congratulate from the depths of my heart and soul the Diplomatic Academy on its 75th anniversary. I speak not only for myself, but on behalf of all my compatriots from the North Caucasus who studied in this outstanding institution. I would like to wish the excellent staff of the Academy good health, professional success, and long and happy lives.
This year I'm defending my thesis.
On the occasion of the Academy's anniversary, I'd like to congratulate all the professors and lecturers who have provided us with such a quantity of knowledge all these years. And I would like to wish them grateful students who, for the rest of their lives, will use the knowledge they gained at the Academy for the benefit of this country.